morning all. So last class we have discussed about the RLTC parameter for various cross section of transmission line, for coaxial line, for two wire line and for parallel plate. Now in today's class we are going to discuss about the solution of wave equation, and with the help of that solution the various things we can determine. Okay, step by step we will see. So let me write first the wave equation. So as we have derived the wave equation in terms of potential and current, so we have to use with respect to that particular streamline. Okay, so first is d square Vs of z by dz square is equals to gamma square Vs of z. This is the first equation, and the second one is d square Is of z by dz square, which is equals to gamma square Is of z. This is the equation 2. Okay, now here these equations I can write as a double derivative second order equation, and it is a homogeneous in nature. Okay, because right hand side, if you take this component to left hand side, right part will become a zero and you can determine the solution. Since it is a double derivative, there will be two solutions will be identified, one positive value and one the negative component. Okay, so these are two Helmholtz equations. Helmholtz equation. Okay, so with the help of these two Helmholtz equation we will identify the solution. Okay, now let me consider the first equation 1. I have d square Vs of z by dz square minus gamma square Vs of z is equals to 0. Done. Now what will be the solution of this? The solution is Vs of z is equals to V0 plus e to the power minus gamma z plus V0 minus e to the power plus gamma z. Now how this particular value comes? As we have double derivative d square y by dx square minus some value in terms of y is equals to 0, then you can write y is equals to c1 e to the power minus x, c2 e to the power plus x. So this is the solution of this above derivative equation. Similarly, this is also a homogeneous equation, which is a second order differential equation, and the solution is Vs of z. Then now here in some of the book this plus sign indicate the incident wave, and this V naught minus is called as reflected wave. When the potential is moving in a transmission line, if it is moving in a positive direction of z, we can take this as incident. If it is a reflected wave, then it is called as a minus, will become as a plus, and the potential is V naught minus. In some of the book this incident wave is called as forward wave. If not to confuse, both are same, and the reflected one is called as backward wave. Done. So this is the solution for the first equation. Similarly, let me take the second one, d square Is of z by dz square minus gamma square Is of z is equals to 0. Done. Now here if you solve this, Is of z is equals to I naught plus e to the power minus gamma z, and I naught minus e to the power plus gamma z. Done. So this is the incident wave with respect to potential, this is the reflected wave with respect to potential. Now same thing here you can write, this is the incident current, incident wave with respect to what? With respect to current. That means I naught plus is the incident one, or you can say This is called as forward wave. Forward wave. Similarly, this is called as reflected wave. Reflected wave, or you can say it is called backward wave. Backward wave. Done. Now, if you see that the relations are quite similar with each other. This is one relation and this is another relation. Now, this I naught plus is equals to V naught plus divided by Z naught. Now, Z naught, what it is, that I will discuss now. Z naught is the characteristic impedance of a transmission line which remains constant throughout the line. At any point, if you measure in those two wire, let us consider this is two wire transmission line. Okay, this is two wire transmission line. So, at any point if you consider, let us consider the length of this transmission line is L. Okay? At any point if you consider, at this point, 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 your Z naught remain constant throughout the system. That is called the characteristics impedance of a transmission line. So, I naught plus I can write V naught by Z naught. Similarly, I naught minus is equals to minus V naught divided by Z naught. Or you can write Z naught is equals to V naught divided by I naught plus for the incident wave, which is equals to minus V naught minus divided by I naught minus. So this is the relation of a characteristics impedance. This is called characteristic impedance, which remain constant throughout the line. At any point if you consider, at Z is equals to 0 or at Z is equals to L, at any point or in between that 0 and L, so your characteristics impedance is going to be remain constant throughout the system. Similarly, so Z naught relation with respect to incident potential and incident current, and reflected current with respect to reflected potential. So this is Z naught. Now what I will do, I will substitute this relation here and I can determine the incident wave and the reflected wave. Okay. So this is the characteristics impedance. Okay. So whatever the thing I have discussed with respect to the wave equation and its solution. Now with the help of that solution, we have determined the characteristics impedance as incident potential divided by incident current minus reflected potential divided by reflected current. So this is called as our characteristics impedance. Remember this, which is remain constant throughout the transmission line. At any point if you identify what is Z naught, it is remain constant. Okay, and maximum value is 75 ohm, not more than that. Now this Z naught we have to determine, but now the question comes, how, what is the value of this Z naught? The Z naught, how we will identify with respect to RLDC term? So we have a certain relation, and that relation will reflect what is the value of Z naught in terms of R, in terms of L, in terms of G, in terms of C. So that is called as our lumped parameter, distributed lumped parameter of a transmission line. Since the constant value RLGC remain constant throughout the system, same it depends upon the characteristics impedance. Okay, let's see. Now, in order to determine this characteristics impedance, we have to go to the time domain analysis. Then only we can see, as we have identified the wave equation in terms of phasor form, independent of time, we have to identify with respect to time domain. So let me take in time domain analysis. So time domain analysis means I will write V of Z comma T is equals to real value of Vs of Z e to the power j omega t. Then, now what is this Vs of Z? Vs of Z we have identified as V naught plus e to the power minus gamma z plus v naught minus e to the power plus gamma z. Then, now what is this gamma value? Gamma value is alpha plus j beta. Substitute here. So, Vs of z is equals to v naught plus e to the power alpha plus j beta whole into z plus v naught minus e to the power alpha plus j beta into z. So this is my Vs of z, because here I have considered in terms of v of t. You can consider with respect to I of z comma t, anyone you can determine. So this value I have to substitute here. Now you can see e to the power j omega t and e to the power j beta z is there. So it will be added with each other, because exponential terms will be added and the constant term will be e to the power minus alpha z. So here I will write v naught plus e to the power minus alpha z. Okay, this is the constant value. Then real part means e to the power j theta, real means cos term. So here I will write cos of omega t minus beta z. Omega t is, because it is plus, so omega t minus beta z, so it is beta z, plus v naught minus e to the power alpha z cos of omega t plus beta z. Then, so this is my v of z comma t. This is the real part of incident wave and this is the real part of reflected wave. So here, with the help of this sort of equation also, you can determine which is the incident wave and which is the reflected wave. Now, in this case, we have considered that my wave is propagating along positive z axis. Okay, so positive z axis means when I will consider the incident wave, if the notation is minus, means omega t minus beta z, that means it indicates that the wave is propagating in a positive z direction. And similarly, when the wave will identify with respect to omega t minus beta z, sometime question will ask in terms of this sort of relation, then you can predict that if it is plus beta z, that means it is reflected back, means from in a negative z direction the wave is propagating. But when it is minus beta z, wave is propagating in a positive z direction. So this is the solution of what? In time domain, v of z comma t. Now this v of z comma t we have identified, and this is the solution of which one? Wave equation. Now we have to determine the characteristics impedance. Okay, now characteristics impedance, we have written Vs of z is equals to v naught plus e to the power minus gamma z. Let us consider only the incident wave, then we can consider for the reflected wave. Then Is of z is equals to v naught plus divided by z naught e to the power minus gamma z. Then now we have a relation, or we have a wave equation. If I will differentiate dVs of z by dz, okay, if I will differentiate this equation, so what I will get? V naught plus minus gamma z and e to the power minus gamma z. So this minus gamma will come into picture, because e to the power minus x means it is minus term. Okay, so here we can write v naught plus e minus gamma e to the power minus gamma z into, this is the total value with respect to Vs of z. Similarly, you can differentiate Is of z by dIs of z by dz. And in the wave equation we have seen minus dVs of z by dz is equals to r plus j omega l into Is of z. Done? So this equation we have used from our wave equation. So what I will do, now I will substitute this value here. So here what I will do, minus V naught plus माइनस गामा इंटू ई टू दी पावर माइनस गामा जेड. दिस वैल्यू आई हैव सब्स्टिट्यूटेड इन दिस इक्वेशन. देन नाउ इट इज आर प्लस जे ओमेगा एल. नाउ व्हाट इज आईएस ऑफ जेड? आईएस ऑफ जेड इज वी नॉट प्लस डिवाइडेड बाय जेड नॉट ई टू दी पावर माइनस गामा जेड. सो हियर आई विल राइट I naught plus e to the power minus gamma z. Done. Simple. Now this minus and this minus will become plus. And e to the power minus gamma z, e to the power minus gamma z will be cancelled out. Because this one and this one will be cancelled out. So we will have v naught plus, take this I naught as denominator, I naught plus, which is equals to R plus J omega L divided by gamma. So this is the characteristics impedance. Then characteristics impedance in terms of V naught plus divided by I naught plus, which is equals to R plus J omega L divided by gamma. Now Z naught we have R plus J omega L, and gamma we have R plus J omega L into G plus J omega C. Now take this quantity within the square bracket, okay, within the square root. So what will happen? We will have Z naught. So this term will become square. So same term is available. So it will be cancelled out. So R plus J omega L divided by G plus J omega C. So this is the characteristics impedance represented in terms of RLGC parameter. Okay. So this is the basic relation how we have derived with respect to lumped parameter, distributed lumped parameter. Distributed lumped parameter, RLGC factor in terms of characteristics impedance. So this is the basic derivation. Some of the book directly they used to write what is Z naught with the help of this relation, but they are not deriving it. But if you know the derivation regarding this determination of Z naught, it will be quite easy to understand that on what factor these values are present. Even you can proceed here. I have proceeded with respect to Vs of Z, incident wave, and with respect to potential, and incident wave with respect to current. Same thing you can proceed for the reflected wave also. So in reflected wave also, same thing we can determine. So same thing, Z naught is equals to R plus J omega L, we will get divided by R plus J omega L into G plus J omega C. So this is my Z naught. So Z naught is equals to how much? Z naught is equals to, it depends upon the lumped parameter, R plus J omega L divided by J omega C. Now in this we can say the characteristics impedance depend upon the complex value, real value and the imaginary value, because it is a complex. If you solve this complex, resultant is again become as a complex. That means it is a combination of real part and imaginary part. So here I can write R naught plus J X naught. So characteristics impedance Z naught is equals to R naught plus minus J X naught. It is plus minus J X naught. Depend upon the parameter of RLGC, you can determine either it is a positive value or it is a negative value. If it is a positive, that means inductive value will be there. If it is negative, it will be a capacitive value will be there. So this is the basic analogy behind the determination of characteristics impedance. This is the characteristics impedance. Done. So now once the characteristics impedance is done, then we can go for the further discussion with respect to different sort of lines are available. What are the lines? Depend upon the mediums. Lossless medium, lossy medium, and distortionless line. So whatever the thing I have discussed till now, it is all about the lossy medium. Means RLGC parameter will be there. Now we will discuss with respect to lossless and distortionless with a certain condition. Okay.
Okay.
So, till now, whatever the thing we have discussed with respect to RLDC parameter, then propagation constant, then phase constant, attenuation constant, whatever it is. So that is with respect to the lossy line, or you can say it is called general line. Okay. So once again, I am going to derive all this thing to learn something. Okay. So lossy line. Lossy line. So as the word lossy line itself indicates that losses will be there. So how the losses will be there? If the RLDC parameter, all parameters are there in a line, then some sort of losses will be there. Okay, that thing in RLDC parameter, if R is there, some energy dissipation is there. If G is there, some conductive dissipation will be there. If L is there, energy stored with respect to magnetic field. If there is a capacitance with respect to dielectric, then energy stored with respect to electric field. This thing will come into picture. Okay, so here in lossy line, the general equation, whatever we have derived, all with respect to lossy line, we have derived all those parameters. So what are the parameter? First is characteristics impedance. So characteristics impedance is R plus j omega L and G plus j omega C. So this is the first characteristics impedance. Second, our propagation constant is R plus j omega L and G plus j omega C. And this value, if we solve, we will get alpha plus minus j beta, whatever the value. Okay, if the alpha is positive, alpha is a frequency independent value, beta is a frequency dependent value. Okay, so this is gamma. Then we can determine the phase velocity with Vp is equals to omega by beta. Then we can determine the wavelength, it is 2 pi by beta. Then, so these are the basic relation. So these are the basic relation for whom? Basic relation for lossy line. Okay, and so phase velocity, lambda, these all parameters are with respect to the lossy line. Similarly, for lossless line, we can write lossless line. So lossless line, here lossless means losses will be there, but it is very very negligible. So how these losses can be minimized? If the condition is R is equals to G is equals to zero. So this is the condition for lossless line. Remember this condition. Okay, so if R is zero, that means energy dissipation is very very less. So maximum energy can be delivered to the load end. Okay, if G is zero, that means the conductive dissipation is also very very less in the medium, and maximum power can be delivered at the load. Our main intention is to deliver the maximum information, maximum potential to a load, so that extraction of information will be easy with the help of transmission line. So if R is equals to G is equals to zero, that means my characteristics impedance, what I will write in this lossy medium is R and G both will be there, but in this lossless medium, R and G both are taken as zero component. If I will substitute zero and zero, I will get only Z naught is equals to root over of L by C. So that means it is only the real value, no imaginary component. Imaginary component will come when it is a lossy line, as well as in distortionless line. We'll see that one. So this is the characteristics impedance. Then, what is our propagation constant? Propagation constant, as you can see, R plus j omega L, G plus j omega C for lossy line. But for lossless, I have to make R and G both as zero. So if R and G both are zero, I will get j omega L into j omega C, where gamma is equals to j omega square, it will come root over of L by C. So what is this? Which is equals to alpha plus j beta. That means alpha is 0 and beta is equals to omega root over of LC. So it indicate what? In a lossless line, it is similar to the air line, in which attenuation constant is 0, but your phase constant is depend upon frequency, that is beta is equals to omega root over of LC. Okay, then we will determine the phase velocity. Phase velocity is omega by beta. So here I will write 1 by root over of L by C. So if it is in a wave in terms of electric field and magnetic field, then we are writing mu into epsilon. We have identified the relation. What is the condition? LC is equals to mu epsilon and G by C is equals to sigma by epsilon. So these are the two relation for a transmission line. So velocity is depend upon mu into epsilon. Same I have written in terms of LC because lump parameter. It is in a transmission line. I can't write with respect to permeability and permittivity. Okay. So once this velocity is known, you can go for the calculation of wavelength. Wavelength is how much? It is 2 pi by beta. So 2 pi divided by omega root over of LC. Then what is omega? It is 2 pi f. So here I will write 2 pi divided by 2 pi f root over of LC. 2 pi cancelled out. So lambda is equals to 1 by f root over of LC. So what is root over of LC? It is a phase velocity. So I will write phase velocity by f. So this is my lambda. This is my phase velocity. Okay. And this is my attenuation constant and phase constant. And this is my characteristics impedance. So these are the certain relation for lossless line. Here we are dealing with the single wave, but if there are a group of wave is propagating, then how to determine the group velocity? The question comes. So group velocity is having a small relation. Remember that in books it is not given. Many of the books they won't discuss about this group velocity. They discuss about different sort of analogy. So group velocity, always remember that the group of wave is going to propagate. Phase velocity means only one wave is going to propagate in a medium. But since one wave is not there, many waves are going to propagate. So I need to calculate the group velocity. Okay. So group velocity is Vg into Vp is equals to C square. Vg is the group velocity of a wave. Vp is the phase velocity of a single wave is equals to C square. If you remember this relation, it is quite easy to determine the group velocity. So group velocity is how much? Group velocity is C square divided by Vp. What is C? C is a speed of light. C is a speed of light. How much it is? Its value is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. So this is my equation for the group velocity. For any medium, the group velocity equation is this. Either you go for lossless medium, either you go for lossy medium, either you go for distortionless line. Okay. So these are the two lines we have discussed. Now we are going to discuss about the distortionless line. So for distortionless line, a certain condition is there. According to that condition, we will derive all these parameters. Okay. So in distortionless line, remember this, there are two points are there. First, in distortionless line, all the waves are propagating with a different velocity, not with uniform velocity. Okay. So different velocity means the RLGC parameter will remain constant, but at the some point it may change, depend upon the dissipation of energy or dissipation of power in that particular line. So when the wave receive at the end, it may not be as a uniform, it will be in a different manner. Okay, so that condition is called as a distortionless line. In distortionless line, dispersion occurs. Dispersion only occurs if it is not propagating with a uniform velocity. If the velocity changes, if the wave, different waves are with having different velocity, then the characteristics will change. And for that characteristics, the distortionless line, as we have written, the lossless line is having a condition R is equals to G is equals to 0. Similarly, the distortionless line is having a condition R by L is equals to G by C. So this is the condition for the distortionless line. And what it is? Two conditions. First, the velocity of the wave is going to change. The different waves are propagating with a different velocity. Second, the attenuation constant is independent of frequency component, and the third one, your phase component is a phase constant depends upon the frequency value. Okay, now let's see, if you substitute this value in this sort of equation, then what is our characteristics impedance, what is our propagation constant, what is our phase velocity, what is our wavelength, and what is our group velocity. This thing we have to calculate. So let's see. So first is characteristics impedance. So characteristics impedance is R plus j omega L divided by G plus j omega C. Now R by L and G is equals to G by C. So what I will do, I will take this L common from the numerator and C common from denominator. So if I am taking, I will get L by C multiply with R by L plus J omega and G by C plus J omega. Then now R by L is equals to G by C, so this value is quite about equal. So equal means this will get cancelled and resultant is 1. So Z naught is equals to L by C. So that means your characteristics impedance remain constant throughout the line. If it is a lossless line, Z naught is root over of L by C. If it is a distortionless line, Z naught is equals to root over of L by C ohm. It is value is only change if it is a lossy medium. This one. Done. So this is my value for characteristics impedance. Next, we are going to calculate about propagation constant. So propagation constant is R plus J omega L and G plus J omega C. Done. Now here, take this R and G common. If you are taking R and G common, you will get this sort of relation. 1 plus J omega L by R, because you have took R common. And from this, 1 plus J omega C divided by G. G is common. Now L by R and C by G both are equal. So it is a square value. So what I will write? Root over of Rg whole into 1 plus j omega L by R. Because it is a square means one term will be removed. So we will get root over of this. Now if you expand this, you will get root over of Rg plus j omega root over of Rg into L by R. So if you take these two component inside, you will get root over of Rg plus j omega root over of Lc. If you take this L by R component inside, R square you will get. So R and this R square will be divided as R, and G into L will become as a C. So it is root over of L by C. So alpha plus j beta is equals to root over of Rg plus j omega root over of Lc. Done. Now with the help of these two, you can determine the attenuation constant and phase constant. So alpha is equals to root over of Rg and beta is equals to omega root over of Lc. So what is the difference with lossless and distortionless line? In lossless, alpha is 0 and beta is equals to root over omega root over of Lc. Similarly, here in terms of distortionless line, your beta remain constant, but alpha is also become as a constant root over of Rg. What is the unit of this? It is Nepper per meter. And what is the unit of beta? It is radian per meter. Remember all these units. So propagation constant is a constant value. Next, we are going to determine lambda. So it is 2 pi by beta, independent of attenuation constant. Remember that. So it is 2 pi divided by omega root over of Lc, 1 by f root over of Lc. Now what is 1 root over of LC? It is phase velocity. I will write phase velocity is omega by beta, which is equals to 1 by root over of LC. So here I can write phase velocity by frequency. Done. So this is my phase velocity. Similarly, groove velocity I can determine Vg into Vp into is equals to C square. So Vg is equals to C square divided by phase velocity. Done. So this is the groove velocity and this is the phase velocity. Wavelength, attenuation constant, phase constant, propagation constant and characteristics impedance. So these are the certain features for identifying which sort of line we are going to use, whether it is a lossless line or whether it is a lossy line. Okay. Okay, fine. So whatever the relation we have derived, it is with respect to lossless line, lossy line and distortionless line. Okay. Now with the help of those things, we can also calculate the different sort of parameter, RLGC parameter for a constant line or transmission line, whatever it is. Now let us consider one example or a question through which we can determine all those parameters using those values. So as I have given, as an airline, it has characteristics impedance is 70 ohm, okay, with a phase constant 3 radian per meter at operating at a 100 megahertz, okay, operating frequency, and we have to calculate the L and C parameter for the transmission line. Okay, now how to proceed this one? First of all, whatever the information is given, let me jot it down. So first is characteristics impedance is 70 ohm is given. Second, beta value is given as 3 radian per meter. And the third one, frequency is 100 megahertz is given. 100 megahertz means 100 into 10 to the power 6, so it is 10 to the power 8 hertz. These are the information. And one most important factor is given as it is an airline. Airline means it is called as lossless line. The lossless other name is called as airline because in air resistive value is zero. Okay, so lossless line condition is what? R is equals to G is equals to zero. So condition we have written. Now it is simple thing is whatever the formula for lossless line, just we have to jot it down and we have to substitute this value there. Okay, so first the characteristics impedance. So what is the characteristics impedance for lossless line? Z naught equals to L by C. Then what is the propagation cost, propagation value? Alpha plus J beta. But here lossless line alpha is 0 and beta is equals to omega root over of LC. Done. Then what is my wavelength? It is 2 pi by beta. What is my phase velocity? It is omega by beta. So these are the relation for lossless line. Now here according to the given value we have to calculate L and C value. Why not R and G? Because lossless line R and G value is 0. We have to calculate L and C. So how to calculate L and C? We have Z naught value, we have beta value. So we can easily find out the value of L and C. So here I can write Z naught is equals to root over of LC, which is equals to 70. So L is equals to 4900 into C. Like this I can write, square this to both this side, take this C right hand side. So L is equals to 4900 C. Next, beta value is equals to omega root over of LC. So root over of LC is equals to beta by omega. So beta is 3 radian, omega is 2 pi into f, f is 8. Done. So this is my LC. So LC is equals to 3 divided by 2 pi into 10 to the power 8 whole square. Done. Take this C component or L component, anything. So L value is how much? 4900. So here I will substitute 4900 C square, because L value is in terms of C. So this is C square. Then it is 3 divided by 2 pi into 10 to the power 8 whole square. Now both are in square term. You can take as 70 C 3 divided by 2 pi into 10 to the power 8. And C value is 3 divided by 70 into 2 pi into 10 to the power 8. So this capacitance value we can determine. So if you are using the calculator, you will get 68.2 picofarad per meter. So C value we have determined. So this is my C. And what is my L? L is equals to 4900 times of C. 4900 into C is 68.2 picofarad per meter, where L is equals to 334.2 nano henry per meter. So this is my L and this is my C. So in this question only it was asked about L and C. If they have asked about what is wavelength, directly we can substitute. Wavelength is equals to 2 pi by beta, where 2 into 3.14 beta value is 3. So here it is near about 3, so equivalent to 2 meter I can write. So this is my wavelength. Similarly, what is the phase velocity? That also we can determine, 2 pi f divided by beta. Okay, so group velocity also we can determine, easy. So group velocity is what? Group velocity is vg c square divided by vp. So what is my vp? Omega by beta. What is omega? 2 pi f. F is this much. What is beta? Beta is 3 radian. So here I have asked only with respect to L and C. In other question they may ask about the other parameters. Okay, so this is the basic process through which we can identify the unknown quantity with the help of the given condition. Most important thing while solving this sort of question, first you determine or identify in that question which sort of line he is asking, whether it is an air line, whether it is a lossless line, or whether it is a lossy line. Here it is given as air line, means indirectly it is asking about the lossless line. What is the condition? R and G both are 0. Okay, and according to that, identify the relation, substitute this value, you will get the unknown quantities. Okay. Okay, so this is one more question. Here I have given with respect to distortionless line. Okay, so you can see a distortionless line characteristics impedance is 60 ohm, attenuation constant is 20 milli Nepper per meter, phase velocity is 0.6 c, where c is the speed of light. And here we have to determine what is the RLDC parameter and the wavelength at 100 megahertz. So with the help of this question, the first information is what? The line is discussed about the distortionless line. Okay, so for distortionless line, let me write the condition first. For distortionless line, so it is R by L is equals to G by C. Then now what are the conditions are given? Its characteristics impedance is Z naught, 60 ohm. But in distortionless line, what is the characteristics impedance? It is root over of L by C over. Second, attenuation constant is 20 milli Nepper per meter. But in distortionless line, what is the value of attenuation? The value of attenuation is Rg. Okay. Now this, and what about the phase velocity? Phase velocity is 0.6 c. And the frequency is given as 100 megahertz. 100 megahertz means 10 to the power 8 hertz. Okay. So these are the information. Now with the help of this relation, L by C is equals to, this I can write R by G also, characteristic impedance. Done. Now here, what are the parameters you have to determine? All the lumped parameter and the wavelength. So with the help of equation 1 and equation 2, you can determine the unknown component. R and G you can determine. If you multiply these two, if equation 1 and 2 multiplied both this side, multiplied. So I will get Z naught into alpha, okay, where in right hand side root over of Rg into root over of, this is R by G and into Rg. So take this inside, you will get R square and GG will be cancelled out, you will get R. So R is equals to how much? Z naught into alpha. Z naught is how much? 60, and alpha is 20 milli, 10 to the power minus 3. So R you can determine as 1200 divided by 1000, so 1.2 ohm per meter. So this is your R. Then, now once R is known, you can determine for the G value also. How to identify G value? Now with the help of equation 2, alpha square is equals to R into G. So G is equals to alpha square by R. Then, so what is alpha square? It is 20 milli Nepper per meter whole square, and alpha R is 1.2. So if you square this, you will get 400 10 to the power minus 6 divided by 1.2. So if you solve this with the help of a calculator, you will get G is equals to 333 microsiemen per meter. So this is your G. Over. Now once this R and G is known, you can go for calculation of L and C. Now how to identify L and C? As we know, velocity is root over of L by C. So use these two relations, Z naught and Vp. You can determine L and C value as I have determined alpha and Z naught. Okay? Because in phase velocity, for any sort of line, it is 1 by root over of Lc. So let us consider this is equation 3. Then, so now I will multiply equation 1 and equation 3. So multiply equation 1 and 3. So what I will get? Z naught into Vp is equals to root over of L by C into 1 by root over of LC. So this is a square value. Take inside, you will get 1 by C. Because C square, so only 1 by C. So capacitance is equals to 1 by Z naught into Vp. So what is Z naught? Z naught is 60. What is Vp? It is 0.6. 3 into 10 to the power 8. So capacity value C you will get around 92.59 picofarad per meter. With the help of calculator solve this, you will get capacitance value. Now R is known, G is known, C is known. We have to determine what is L. It is easy one. Use this characteristics impedance. Equation 1. Z naught square is equals to L by C, where L is equals to Z naught square into C. So it is 3600 into 92.59 picofarad per meter. So our L will have, it is 3 नैनो हेनरी पर मीटर. सो एल ऑल्सो वी हैव डिटरमाइंड, आर ऑल्सो वी हैव डिटरमाइंड, जी ऑल्सो वी हैव डिटरमाइंड एंड सी ऑल्सो वी हैव डिटरमाइंड. वॉट इज दी अनदर फैक्टर वी हैव टू डिटरमाइन? लैम्डा. सो वॉट इज दी वैल्यू ऑफ लैम्डा? लैम्डा इज इक्वल्स टू 2π/β. देन नाउ वॉट इज बीटा? इट इज 2π/ω root over of LC. So L and C value is known, substitute here. Omega value is 2πf. So 2πf, f is how much? 10 to the power 8. Substitute everything. You will get lambda is equals to 1.8 meter. Okay. So like this, you can calculate n number of questions with respect to the given condition, whether it is a lossless line, whether it is a lossy line, or whether it is a air line, any sort of line. Okay, so these are the two simple examples through which you can identify this relation. I have prepared few questions for your assignment in this week. By Sunday or by Monday, next week, this weekend or next Monday, I will share that assignment question in which total 10 questions are there, or I can give a 5 question. According to that, you have to solve it. Okay, and each question will carry a 5 marks. So that assignment total 3 assignments or 4 assignments I will prepare for you people, in which you have to calculate as well as you have to simulate the values, because this thing can be simulated with respect to MATLAB also. Okay. So these are the simple questions. Related to this, few more questions we will solve in the next class after discussion of few more parameters like input impedance, reflection coefficient, transmission coefficient, as well as input impedance for different sort of lines are there. As we have identified the types of line, there are other some special cases are there, like open circuit line, short circuit line, match line. Depend upon that, what are the parameters will come into picture. According to that, I have framed 10 questions. That 10 questions I am going to solve in your class, and these are the things which help you in your exam, because in exam nobody knows which sort of questions will come, but if you know the basic thing, it is very easy to understand. Okay, so tomorrow we will continue with respect to the other part of our transmission line, that is called input impedance. We have to determine for the transmission line. You have to calculate the standing wave ratio, you have to calculate reflection coefficient, you have to calculate transmission coefficient, because these are the certain parameters which helps to identify, these are the additional parameters which helps to identify the working principle of a transmission line. Okay, so today I will end up at this point. So we will continue next class. Thank you all.